Hello everyone, and welcome to another GTA 5 on Linux video. Today I'm going to investigate the state of modding GTA 5 on Linux. A few of you have requested this video, going all the way back to the very first video I made showcasing GTA 5 running on Proton, and today your prayers have finally been answered. So, without much further ado, let's get into it. Now, I will say I haven't ever really done much GTA 5 modding myself in the past, even when I was still a filthy Windows peasant. The most I ever really did was install Scripthook 5 and the native trainer, maybe a couple of other ASI scripts too. So some of the mods I'll be showing off in this video I actually had to figure out for the very first time myself, and it was made all the more difficult because I'm having to deal with wine as well. That said, I was very pleasantly surprised with how much I was able to achieve, and hopefully you will be too. So, starting with the very basics, let's go over Scripthook 5 and the native trainer. To get this to work with Proton, there's really only one extra step that you have to do compared to installing it on Windows. So, download Scripthook 5, put the files in your GTA 5 installation folder, and if we were on Windows, then we'd be good to go. But since we're on Linux and we're running GTA 5 through a compatibility layer, there's one little thing that we need to tweak first. The way that Scripthook 5 works is by replacing a DLL file with one that has been modified to allow injecting user scripts into GTA 5. The thing about Wine and Proton is it comes with its own modified DLL files for certain Windows components to maximize compatibility. And by default it will prefer to use those ones over the native Windows DLLs or the DLLs that are placed into application folders. So since Scripthook 5 uses a modified dinput8.dll to work, we need to tell Proton to use this DLL instead of the Wine version. It's quite a simple tweak. First of all, you make sure you have Wine installed on your system. Shouldn't matter what version of Wine you have, whether it's stable or staging. I have Wine staging 3.20 on my system. Next, let's open up a terminal and type in all caps Wine prefix equals. A Wine prefix can be thought of as like a Windows installation. Each Wine prefix contains a folder that acts as a C drive and also contains a Windows registry. Each Proton game you have installed will have its own Wine prefix. So we need to find out where our GTA 5 Wine prefix for Proton is. If you haven't set up a custom Steam installation folder, then it will be in your home folder, /.local/share/steam/steamapps/compat.dat/271590/pfx. Now this number 271590 corresponds to the game ID. This is the ID that GTA 5 has, and every game will have its own unique ID. If you want to find out the ID for a game that you have installed, then a quick way is to open up the Steam store in a browser and search for the game's store page. The URL for the store page will contain the ID. So now we've got our Wine prefix typed in, let's add a space and type winecfg. This will now open a configuration utility that lets you change certain settings for your Wine prefix, and of course we've told it to use our GTA 5 prefix instead of the default Wine prefix. Click on the Libraries tab, and in this box type dinput8, then click Add. This will add an exception to the Wine prefix that tells it to use the dinput8.dll file in the installation folder instead of the one that comes built into Wine. Now, when you launch GTA 5 from Steam and load into the game, you should be able to hit F4 and bring the native trainer up. Nice. If you can get this far, then installing other ASI scripts should be nice and simple from now on. No more extra steps will be required. So, that covers Scripthook 5 and ASI scripts. But what about other scripthooks? Unfortunately, it seems as though installing the .NET script hook will cause the game to crash while loading up. Hopefully someone smarter than me can figure out a way to fix this. The Lua plugin for Scripthook 5 seems to be working absolutely fine though. I haven't tested Rage plugin hook, and I suspect that it won't work due to the fact that it uses a custom launcher. even if it does work, the amount of fiddling that would be needed to get Proton to use the custom launcher would require a video all on its own, and I don't feel like making a mess. So if you know what you're doing and want to try this out, then let me know how it goes. Let me know in the comments if there are any other script hooks or programming language plugins that I've missed, but for now, that'll do it for custom scripts. Now, onto the juicier stuff. OpenIV works in Wine, but it isn't perfect. Annoyingly, all of the problems that I've encountered seem to be incompatibilities with custom UI elements. I'm sure OpenIV looks very pretty running on native Windows, but on Wine, it's kind of a shit show, even though all the backend functionality works fine. Certainly, the biggest problem with these UI bugs is the fact that for OpenIV mods to work, you need to download openiv.asi. But the ASI manager that comes with OpenIV, the only way I've found to obtain this ASI file, doesn't render anything in Wine. So in order to get the openiv.asi file, you need to open the ASI manager, then blindly hit tab and enter a few times to try and select then initialize the download. Doing this too many times can then uninstall the openiv.asi file and potentially uninstall scripthook 5 as well. So you need to have a file manager open in your GTA 5 install folder to keep an eye on what you're doing. Look, I get that GTA 5 isn't officially supported on Linux, so why would GTA 5 modding tools be supported on Linux? But it's incredibly frustrating when the modding tool runs in Wine and all of the functionality to modify the RPF files and whatnot works perfectly, but the tool is almost unusable because the developer decided to include some quite frankly pointless eye candy to the UI and didn't provide an alternative way to obtain the openiv.asi file. Why not have an option to enable a more basic UI? Why not have an option to download the openiv.asi file from the website? Why do I have no option but to download it through the tool? Again, I understand that Linux and Wine support is probably not even on the OpenIV team's radar, and there's not really any reason that it should be. But if you just used native UI elements instead of all this pointless custom stuff, then there wouldn't be any problems here. Whatever, rant over. The good news is that after some fumbling around, you can get the openiv.asi file to download, and you can modify RPF files within OpenIV in Wine. So custom map mods, custom car mods, custom weapon mods, etc. should all work fine on Linux. The only thing that's potentially a bit tricky is pointing OpenIV to your GTA 5 installation. The way I did it is by creating a symbolic link to my GTA 5 installation within the Wine prefix where I installed OpenIV. So, in conclusion, with the exception of .NET scripts, everything seems to work pretty well. Modding GTA 5 on Linux is very much possible. There's just a few extra hoops to jump through and a few added annoyances to work around. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you in the next one.